Hello there everyone, welcome back again with another video. In this video, we are going to create all the participant certificates using Certificate Authority. So at the initial stage of this video series, we have created all the certificate using CryptoGen tool. But CryptoGen tool is not recommended for the production use case. So in case if you are deploying your application in the production, so in that case, you should use Certificate Authority instead of CryptoGen tool. So In this video, we will be creating all the certificate of the network using Certificate Authority, like peer certificate, admin certificate, organization admin certificates, user certificates. All the certificates we are going to create using Certificate Authorities. So in our network, we have two organizations. First one is the order organization and second one is the peer organization. You can see here, in our network, we have two organizations, order organization and peer organization. So inside peer organization, again, we have two organizations, org1 and org2. So total, we have three organizations, one order organization and two peer organization. So previously, we have used Certificate Authority org1 and Certificate Authority org2 for the two organizations. But after bootstrapping the network, we have used the Certificate Authority to register and enroll the new users. But we have bootstrapped our network using all the certificates which are created by CryptoGen tool. Right now, we will have total three Certificate Authority, Organization 1 Certificate Authority, Organization 2 and Order Certificate Authorities. Coming to the certificate validation, one of the most important thing in Hyperledger Fabric is the certificate validation. It's not related to Fabric, actually it's a general term, certificate validations. So before going to the certificate validation, so first of all, we should be aware about the encryption and hashing. So let's discuss little what is the encryption. Encryption is the process of converting plain text into the ciphertext, and decryption is the process of converting that ciphertext into again plain text. So we have multiple algorithms. One of them is the symmetric algorithm, another is the asymmetric algorithm. In symmetric algorithm, generally we encrypt the text using some particular key and decrypt that ciphertext again using the same keys. That is the symmetric encryption. What is asymmetric encryption? So in asymmetric encryption, user will have two keys, public key and the private key. So that user can encrypt that text using one of the key and decrypt with the other keys. You should be clear with this encryption. Coming to the hashing. Hashing is the irreversible function. So once we created a hash, we cannot recover what was the input. What is purpose of this hashing then, if we are not able to create or recover the input? When we talk about the certificate validation, I will let you know. Here we can see, we are going to create some public key and private key, and using that public key and private key, we will be encrypting and decrypting some of the text. So how generally it works, I will show you. So first of all, so we will generate some public key and private key, RSA keys actually. So here you can see, this is the public key and this is the private key. Okay, so using these two keys, we will be playing with the encryption and decryption. So first of all, here I will add one text. This is test text. So we are going to encrypt this with private key of just we have created here. I'm adding here and we're encrypting with the private key. So we're encrypting that text and we got this encrypted output. That is the base64. And how we can recover the original text? We have encrypted with the private key. So anyone who has the public key of this user, they can decrypt this text. Let's assume here we can see, we are adding this base64 encrypted text here. And here we have to add the public key because we have encrypted the text using private key. So it means only public key can decrypt that original text. This is the text actually. We'll use this public key here. Let me check this public key, and we can decrypt this so that after clicking on the decrypt button, we should get the original text. This is the test text. Here you can see. So we can encrypt and decrypt with this public key and private key. So this concept plays very vital role in the certificate validations. I will let you know. So after this is the encryption, and coming to the hash, let's assume that we are going to calculate some of the hash. Let's here I will mention this all these two website link in the description. Generate hash of the string you input. Let's assume I am adding power 1 and it's creating hash 256. So after each stroke it's getting changed. You can see just I am adding something. You can see, you can observe here that it's getting changed whole. At each keystroke, it's getting changed. So we cannot even guess as well, means what was the input using this hash. And this is the fixed length hash. It's 256 bit and it changes. You can enter anything here. It will create only 256 bit hash. How this encryption and hashing plays vital role in the certificate validation, because generally what we are using in certificate authorities, we are using X509 standard certificates. Okay, so let's see how certificate work. Here is the certificate. It's a X509 standard certificate. Generally what exactly contained in the certificate. Let's assume here is the Sandeep is the user, and in certificate generally have that users in ID informations, users public key, CA information, and finally the digital signature. So this is the CA information who have signed this certificate. So let's check one certificate. Let's see one of the certificate. Artifacts channel. Crypto. Peer organizations. Org1. Users. Admin. MSP. Sign search. Yeah, here. We have one certificate. Oh, sorry. LS. So we have here certificate. Let's open that certificate. Open SSL. X509 in certificate name -1 text. Here you can see we have all the information here: version, serial number, issuer, who is the issuer, certificate authority, validity of the certificate, subject, public information of the user, to whom that certificate is given. These all the information is there. And finally at here you can see digital fingerprint, signature algorithm is this one, and this is the signature. You can see these all the information just we have seen here. In user information, users public key, certificate authority information. So who is the certificate authority? So let's assume we have created the certificate certificate for the organization 1, and in our network we have one certificate authority for the organization 1, that is the dedicated certificate authority for organization 1. So that certificate authority created this certificate, and let's assume that so this certificate authority have information about the organization 1 certificate authority. Here, so just before some time I already showed how encryption and hashing works. So whenever if someone get the certificate, what exactly happened, how they validate if the certificate is valid or not. So first of all, while creating the certificate, when we request for the certificate to the certificate authority, in that case the certificate authority physically validated all the documents of that user, and after that only it gives the certificate to the user. So It means we are trusting the certificate authority. Here you can see this is the information, user information, public key and the certificate information. So certificate authority, what it does, first of all it create the hash of this information using hashing algorithm. And let's assume that for this information, first one Sandeep ID information, Sandeep public key and the certificate authority information, it create a hash using this hashing function. Here you can see the hash, the certificate authority created the hash. After that, this hash, what certificate authority does, it encrypt this hash with his private key, certificate authority's private key, and put it as a digital signature here. You can see, just try to understand, this is a very important step actually. So first one, certificate authority encrypt this information at the upper side of the information, it create a hash. So first of all, certificate authority create a hash of this information, upper side information. This is the user information and the certificate authority information. And I just showed you what exactly contained in the actual certificate. This is more or same. So certificate authority create a hash of this information using hashing algorithm this. And after that, once that hash get created, certificate authority encrypt that hash using its own private key. There is a typo here, it's a private key actually. Here, once encryption of that hash, it put as a digital signature. And finally, this certificate will get created and certificate authority gives that certificate to the user. So let's assume now, this part is, left side part is done. Now user have this certificate here, at this certificate, X509 standard certificate. This is the general procedure validating the certificate. Whenever they get certificate here, the first of all this, they can verify the certificate if that is the valid certificate or not. So how it can be done? So first of all, they will, so whoever is the validating the certificate, first of all they can calculate the hash of this information here, just exactly same what we have, the certificate authority have done here. They will calculate the hash of this information, upper side, user information, public key and the CA information. So we will get some hash here. And later, we have a digital signature as well here at the bottom of the certificate. This digital signature, so first of all, this certificate have certificate authority information as well. So it means, so whoever is the verifying the certificate, first of all, he take this certificate authority's public key and decrypt this digital signature using this certificate authority public key. Once that digital signature is get decrypted, again we will get some text, that is the hash. If these both hash are equal, it means that certificate is valid, signed by this certificate authority. So in case if someone have tempered some certificate, someone have done some changes in certificate here, this hash function will create a different hash, because if the content of the certificate will change, then it will create some little different hash, and these two hash will not match. This hash has this one and this one. So it means someone have tempered the certificate and that certificate will get invalidated, means that is not a valid certificate. Another one thing, if this certificate is even though valid, but how we can confirm that it is signed by some specific certificate authority like organization 1 or organization 2? Because if someone other is also creating some certificate, they will also have this information, and we can create this hash exactly same, and that could be a valid certificate. But here, in case we are creating the certificate using certificate authority organization 1, it means we will have this information, certificate authority information of that organization only, organization certificate authority only. So using that certificate authority, we can say that this is the valid certificate authority and the certificate is also valid. Generally, the validation takes place exactly same what I just told here. First of all, calculate hash and after that, encrypt that. here digital signature will get created. It's created by the certified authority, and later on anyone can validate that information, because public key of the certified authority is available inside the certificate, and that is the public. Anyone can validate that. If someone is trusting that certificate authority, it means they can trust on the certificate as well. And here these two hashes will be same. So how we can validate that? So I already told. So here, if we are encrypting any text using some key that is public key or private key, we can decrypt that. We can recover the original text using decrypt with the other keys. So here I already showed you. So here I already showed you public key, private key we have created, and using this public key, private key we have encrypted and the decrypted text. So finally we got the exactly same what was the input. And here as well we will get same. So this hash is nothing but this information hash. Okay, so we are encrypting this hash and putting as a digital signature. So of course this will be done by the certificate authority, and whoever has this certificate, again they can calculate the hash of this information, this one, and this digital signature that can be decrypted using the certificate authority's public key, and again we will get some hash, and these two hash would be exactly equal if the certificate information is exactly certificate information is correct. If there is some change in the certificate, then this hash would get create something different, and these two hash will not match. So that time the certificate will not be valid, and anyone can invalidate the certificate using this scenario. In our Hyperledger Fabric as well, so we have all the organization's MSP information in the configuration block. So inside that MSP we have certificate authority information. Who is the certificate authority for this organization? Organization 1, organization 2, and organization 3. Here you can see organization 1, inside the MSP we have this certificate authority, this caorg1example.com, and this is the certificate. So using this certificate we can validate if this certificate information and that certificate information is matching. It means this certificate is signed by that certificate authority, that proper certificate authority, that is organization 1 or organization 2, depends. For validating this information, let's do it on that website. So first of all, we have some information. ABCD is the information, and we got this hash. Let's assume that right now, for that ABCD information is nothing but this information, this user information and certified authority information. Okay, so we got hash here, this hash. Now what we are going to do, this hash we will encrypt with certified authority's private key. So first of all, here this hash we are putting here, that is a plain text right now, and using this private key so we will be encrypting this information using this private key. Let's assume this certificate authority is doing this all this stuff. Using private key of the certificate authority, we are encrypting this hash, encrypt. Okay, we got this. We will be putting this information as the digital signature. Now in our certificate we will have this information, this one. Okay, and finally if whoever has this information, so again we can calculate the hash of this information. The hash would be exactly same, that hash would be exactly same, this one, if that certificate is not tampered. Now what we will do, we will decrypt this digital signature. In our case this is the digital signature, and in certificate we have certificate authority's information and it have public key as well for the certificate authority. Now we will decrypt this information using public key of the certificate authority. So at the initial stage we have created public key and private key for the certificate authority. So Right now, we are acting as a certified authority while encryption and while decrypting. A public key is the public, so everyone will know, and certificate also will have this information. So private key, it's a confidential, and only certificate authority will have this private key. Now here, we're adding this public key here, and when we decrypt it, the procedure here, now we are decrypting with public key of the certificate authority. We are getting this hash. This hash and this hash should be same. So now I'm decrypting now. You can see here for this information we have created hash this one, and exactly this hash is also same, and just we have decrypted this is signature and we got hash. These two hash should be same. These two hash should be exactly same, and you can see here 88D4266 exactly same are there. It means that certificate is valid and no one have tampered that certificate. And if the certificate authority information is correct, it means what you are expecting, there could be a lot of certificate authority as well. So in your case, if you feel that certificate should be signed by organization one certificate authority and this information is correct and matching with the certificate authority one organization, so in that case you can mark this certificate as a valid and maybe proceed with the transaction. That's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. In case if you are facing any issue, just let me know in the comment section, so I will try to solve that. In case if you feel something is wrong, just let me know. I will try to correct it, and probably I will correct the video as well. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for the more update.